We're gonna go try getting that car back there so we can ride it again. Yabba dabba doo.
Germany surrendered unconditionally. Now let's give a huge round of applause for all those who took part in D-Day. Now we must never forget the brave sacrifice that has been made and is still being made in the cause of freedom, especially when this country stood alone against Hitler and his evil Nazi regime. When after the fall of France, they were only 20 miles away across the English Channel, when Hitler looked across and he said to Hermann Göring, "We shall land on British soil." What he hadn't anticipated was the bravery of our fighter pilots and our wonderful Spitfires and Hurricanes. Never in the field of human conflict was so much over, were I so many, for so few. I would now like to recall for you an extract from the Battle of Britain speech, which I broadcast to this nation during the country's darkest hour to stiffen the resolve to fight on. I speak to you as your Prime Minister, and above all, the cause of freedom. We are now threatened with a planned invasion by the Nazi tyranny. We will not yield to Hitler's greed for world domination. So now it's come to us to stand alone in the breach, face the worst the tyrant can do. We are ready to defend our native land from the invasion by which it is now threatened. Shielded by our navy, our airmen from above, we await undismayed by the impending invasion. Perhaps it might come tonight, as it might come next week, or as it may never come. But be the ordeal long or short, we shall seek no terms, we shall seek no parley. Hitler has not yet been withstood by a country with a willpower equal to his own. We shall defend every village, every town, every city. We'd rather see London laid in ruin than tamely submit and be enslaved. I am bound to state such facts and inform our people of our intentions and thus reassure them around us lies the strength of the Royal Navy and the protection of our airmen. I stand ahead of a government with one bond that unites us all, namely that we shall endure whatever lies ahead to preserve the cause of freedom. You ask, what is our policy? It is to wage war by sea, land and air with all our might and with all the strength God can give us, to wage war against a monstrous tyranny never surpassed in the dark and lamentable catalogue of human crime. That is our policy. You ask, what is our aim? I can answer in one word: victory. Victory at all costs. Victory in spite of all terror. Victory, however long and hard the road may be. For without victory, there is no survival. The Battle of France is over, and the Battle of Britain is about to begin. Soon the whole fury and might of the enemy will be turned upon us. We have before us an ordeal of the most grievous kind. We have before us many, many long months of struggle and of suffering. I have nothing to offer but blood, toil, tears and sweat. We shall go on to the end. We shall fight on the seas and the oceans. We shall fight with growing confidence and with growing strength in the air. We shall defend our island, whatever the cost may be. We shall fight on the beaches. We shall fight on the landing grounds. We shall fight in the fields and in the streets. We shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender. Upon this battle depends the future of all civilization. Upon it depends our own British life and all that Britain is. Hitler knows that he will have to break us in this island or lose the war. If we can stand up to him, then all of Europe may be free, and the world can move forward into broad, sunlit uplands. But if we fail, then the whole world, including the United States, including all that we have known and cared for, will sink into the abyss of a new dark age, made more sinister and more protracted by the lights of averted science. Let us therefore brace ourselves to our duties, and so bear ourselves. The British Empire and its Commonwealth last for 1,000 years. Men will still say, this was their finest hour. Advance Britannia, long live the cause of freedom, and God bless you all. Thank you.
I want to be a part of you.